morning. Got 5 centimeters yesterday afternoon, and it kind of stopped them behind overnight. On top of the 15 we just got Monday, and I didn't record it because it was early in the morning. I was here probably around 6. I always like to get this place done first when it snows big time. So again, we got 5 centimeters last night. Nothing big, but they're open today, so I said I'd come over and run around for an hour. It's a nice morning. It's cold as hell. So I just unlocked the gate like 10 minutes ago, and I thought, hey, I got my holder, so I'll throw the phone up for a bit. Very light, 5 centimeters, nothing big. Should literally be able to whip through this in like an hour or so. This damn partition. Yeah, we got 15 or so centimeters on Monday night. Monday was a holiday, so. It was really warm yesterday and really cold right now. It's like minus 17, minus 16, something like that. As you can see the exhaust. You never see the exhaust on a diesel when it's warm enough out. Pretty frozen up, so it's bumpy as hell because all the cars drive up and down this the most in this place. I've only been up for like maybe half an hour or so, guys, so bear with me. It's another reason I don't like recording in the mornings, because I'm not quite awake yet. Is there ever a lot of slush under here? It's a nice light snow, but a lot of rough shit underneath it. Is so dirty I can barely see out the windows. I'd like to try to get this done within the hour because I believe they open at 9. Front parts anyway. If I run down the other side, not a big deal. This stupid stop sign sitting here they put here. Oh my God. The only vehicle sitting back here, and it has to be a freaking truck. Otherwise, I could just skate right through the whole thing there. I figured I'd take this opportunity now because we haven't got a shitload of snow this year at all. We've actually got only like 2 massive snowfalls, which were only about 15 centimeters each. Everything else has just been this little 2, 3 to 5 centimeter kind of stuff. But I'd rather plow 5 centimeters of light snow than fucking heavy wet crap. I'm my little area back here where I usually back drag from the container. Somebody stuck a goddamn little car in there, so that's going to be interesting. Keeps the owner from getting sued. That's what they want. Yeah, I'm not talking a whole lot here yet, guys. I like literally just woke up. Grabbed a coffee and went back to my garage for about 20 minutes and pretty much guzzled it down in 10. Not how I like to drink my morning coffee. But I didn't want to try to bother bringing it with me here because it would have been freaking cold within 5 minutes. Probably not going to do an outside video. I don't know how straight you guys are, but I just kind of threw it up quick. Last minute thing just because everything was with me. Truck's not even quarter of the way warmed up yet. Freaking diesels, minus 17. Takes a while to warm up. Temperature gauge has barely moved off the zero mark. This is not normally how I would do the front of this, but somebody decided to park some cars around this side, so that's the way I gotta do it. Usually the front of this building is empty. Because of COVID, they wanted to keep it empty so people could park here. Oh, one more. The snow pile's getting a little big. I'm starting to stick out into the freaking new car section here. Little section. Hard to be quick when you gotta be tedious. Hey guys, I don't know what the hell happened there. I just looked at the phone and it was off. Not off, but not recording. Can't get my little groove back here because the supercar's in the way. I probably could squeeze back there a little bit, but not gonna bother. Not for 5 centimeters. You guys are somewhat straight. Toothpaste and coffee. Just really raw. Should have grabbed my drink. Yeah, I don't know what the hell happened to my camera. I was sitting here chatting away to you and I looked up and the fucking thing was off. It was on my homepage. The sun, guys. I gotta go this direction though for this part anyway. guys can hear that belt squeak or not. It goes away once the truck's warmed up, which is not yet quite warmed up. Man, those are stupid looking cars. See if I can get this back section done before people start showing up here. Oh, what's this lake back here? Frozen over or full of dirt? Keep my eye up on this phone here when it gets to the 10 minute mark. I don't change any settings, so it shouldn't be stopping on its own anyway. Wow, those snow piles are cold. Sorry guys, I'm not talking a whole lot, I know, but I'm not really a morning person. Up on the 10 minute mark again on this video. I want to see if it stops on its own, because even though if it usually it just rolls over to the next phase of the video, it doesn't stop on me usually. I don't remember changing any settings. So if I have to keep manually starting this video every time it stops on me, it's gonna suck. Thanks for a bit of a weird editing job. Yep. Yeah, that's weird. It's stopping. Why is it stopping on me every 10 minutes? Rough little spot here to do, guys, but I don't have a choice but to do it this way since somebody parked a fucking goddamn truck there. This is where all the hard dirt usually gets covered with cars, so the snow doesn't really pack down here. Sunday now. Doing that never does that. It always records 10-minute clips at once, but it keeps recording. Now it's stopping after 10 minutes, and I gotta watch it so I can manually restart recording. I said I didn't hit any settings, so I don't know why it's doing that all of a sudden. Oh, here comes the first worker. Turbo diesel, heavy duty. I'm trying to figure out what year that is. It's got a dry ass frame on it, whatever year it is. Say it's a 12. Maybe it's an 07 actually, now that I see the front. I never understood why Ram went with the round hood or with the drop fenders and the way they design them. I know this one's the same way too, but I mean, the old ones were always just a flat hood. Square hood, whatever. God, it's rough under here. Bucket sand. Look at that sand. These guys park cars in the random fucking spots. outside video, it would just be loud. And now that this phone's only collecting 10 minutes per video here, it wouldn't work out for me. Cold morning for skidooing, but at least the sun's out. Let's see how close I can get to these fucking containers. Without hitting one. Enough to the door to get these. There we go. Fucking phone's gonna stop again. Weird, it starts flashing at 9:50, like, so I have to record it manually when it stops at 10. I never had to do this before. So stupid. Side, it's the worst. There's big rocks under here. They're sticking up out of the frozen snow. Well, guys, I apologize in advance if this video is a little chopped up during editing, but I didn't know it was going to stop on its own like that. That's definitely new to me. If I hit a setting or if the freaking camera updated and that's the way it's running, which would be really stupid. see that strip on the left that I just hit? All the goddamn stones and shit sticking out of the freaking ice. Video stops on me the way it is, I'm gonna get right out of this setting and see if anything changed. The only thing I could think of is, well, when I first started doing this, I put the camera up on the suction cup, went to lock the suction cup to the windshield, and it didn't lock, and it fell on the passenger floor. So I don't know if it, when it fell, the something actually hit the screen and changed the setting. It has never done this before. It's a good thing I was paying attention the whole time. Just sitting here talking to you guys, recording absolutely nothing for an hour. Which actually wouldn't be the first time. A couple years ago, I had the older Samsung, and it had a very weak battery in it. Some reason when it used to get down into the 30% stage, the battery would die at 30%. So I remember doing this a couple years back, recording a video, looking at the phone like 20 minutes after I said it, and there was nothing even on the screen, it was off. I was like, what the hell? What a waste of my time. Trying to go slow as well as it's bumpy back here, but really trying to go slow so the snow doesn't spray up all over the windshield for you guys. This windshield's pretty dirty too. I should clean it. The inside. Done doing this. This is all I'm doing today. I told myself I wasn't doing anything else this weekend because I've been plowing nonstop for the freaking whole week, pretty much. Anyway, when I'm doing this, I have to go exchange some Nike Airs I bought just before Christmas. Well, I bought them, but my wife actually ended up giving them me for part of my Christmas present. And I know there's a skid around here somewhere in front of these damn dumpsters. Anyways, I wore them a week and the freaking side of the front of the shoe, the glue started letting go. After 5 days of wearing the damn things, and I even put protection on them and everything, like the protectant spray and everything on them, $10 worth. They must have been faulty pair of shoes though, for one just to start letting go. I actually have the same pair on right now that I've had for 3 years, and I didn't get the first hole in these things for the first 2 years. So yeah, I gotta take a little bit of a jolt drive today and exchange those. Now that the lockdown is over here, I was supposed to take them back about a month and a half ago, but the day I was going to, they decided they weren't taking returns because there was going to be a lockdown days later. So they changed all the crap around. So the lockdown was lifted this Tuesday that just passed, 3 days ago, 4 days ago. And the phone's gonna stop again soon. Why it's doing that. Picture settings. I don't see anything out of place. So weird. Oh shit. Halfway done here. Just got all this left side of this lot to do. That's all I'm doing. steam in that hood. That's about as hot as it is in the cab. It's fucking hot in here. I got my driver's window and the back window cracked open. Well, the driver's window's open all the way, the back window's open halfway. I didn't see anything on this phone that would have changed when it dropped. Mind you, I don't go through my settings in my camera very often. It's just set where it always is. I never change anything. So I may have to reset my settings if I can't find anything, which wouldn't change anything either because I don't change anything. It's always sitting at 60 frames per second. Jagged everywhere down here. This is where it's a really bad spot to put this phone. This is blocking my right view a little bit, so I gotta be careful here. You can barely even see the guide where my phone is sitting right now. Yeah, this is really dumb, whoever parked these cars. Pretty narrow in there. Oops, wasn't in first there either. If this thing stops on its own at 10 minutes again, I'm like counting it down. It's a pain in the ass when you gotta watch what your phone's doing too. I'm hoping it was just a fluke and it just needed to be turned off and reset. starts doing that shit again. His lineup is so out of whack. So out of whack. Oh, I love these tires for the snow. They work so much better than the other ones did. Still doing the goddamn fucking camera. What the hell? I don't know what the hell's wrong with this phone. I gotta stop here because I gotta get all the snow at the end. God damn it. This is a bit of a pain in the ass, but I've been in a video, guys. Thank you. was a little carried away with my method to my madness. I've done this a lot so many times. The routine never changes, depending on how much snow there is, anyway. the blade straight on here so you can get a little spray. I gotta cut this line down a little. It'll take forever for a little bit of snow. Too before my wife's clients start fucking rolling in. My wife has a lash appointment that I forgot was coming at 9 o'clock. It's already 10 after. There's gonna be a car on my way to do my own driveway now, probably. Side and I'm pretty much gone. Thank you.
sprayed a little bit. Ankles.
Oh well. I'm sure you won't notice it. Snow on the roads, and they're salting and plowing the shit out of it. Most people really wouldn't care about the amount of snow that's on the ground compared to what there was on Monday. Literally, like, I think there's like 4 or 5 centimeters on the ground that happened overnight. Tall roof with a really little narrow driveway, as you guys know, and when it gets mild, the icicles form on the top of the roof and they fall into the side of my driveway and basically freeze into the snow. This phone is acting really weird this morning. I just looked at it and the screen was dark. Like, my brightness went right down on its own. Okay, there's nobody here yet. That's good. There's not much in here, but it's the stuff on the side that I want to try to get out of here. Oh my god, my mirrors are so dirty, I can barely see the back out of here. And of course, I just left a big boulder sitting here. Driveway's getting pretty rough. Oh, you fucking bitch. Now it's gonna be rough. Oh, that's the ice that's fallen here. Probably not back dragging it. It would be a better thing to do. See all that in there? Sitting against the house? I'm gonna have to drive that out because it's just frozen. Front lawn for my wife, make her happy so her clients can get in the house easier. And I'll probably do my neighbor's driveway just because I'm a nice guy. Thank you. Oops. I took one of my wife's flowers down. You thought my driveway was small. His gas meter is right there on the left. And then I gotta try squeezing out of here. Nope, that's not working very well. It's easier to get in here than it is to get out for some reason. Guardrail right here doesn't help. And I have to back in both the driveways. Guys, that's all I really got. I'm gonna go in and have another coffee before I have to head out and take these shoes back. So, I thought I'd do that snowfall video. It wasn't much, but it's something. Like I said, I don't know how much we're gonna get this year. So, I'm just gonna pull back in my driveway and have a coffee and get going. So, again, thanks for watching, guys. Until next time.